Hi, my name is Marthe Poulin. I teach at the Commission scolaire de la Beauce et Chemin and l'École des Deux-Rives. I am a teacher in Enriched English Secondary 1. I've been teaching since 1990, do the math. I was a consultant for a while, for 9 years, and I came back to teaching because it's fun. I teach students who are in Citoyens du Monde. Citoyens du Monde comes from the Commission scolaire des navigateurs. We've been teaching in Citoyens du Monde for the past over 10 years, and we have sort of tweaked it a bit with technology, so students have, they use technology every day in class, in French, in math, in English, in geography also. So for the use of technology, sometimes it's good, other days it's bad. You always have to have a backup. Technology I find for class is fun because you get the point across quicker with the students. Students love to just search on the internet. Students in high school, they have their own devices also. So once in a while when we do a Kahoot, like they'll just open their own device instead of opening the computer. So I accept that with no problem. Sometimes they'll just research something and instead of turning around, if they're in groups working, brainstorming on something, if they want to research something very quickly, sometimes they'll just take their own device, look it up very quickly instead of taking the computer also. A lot of the times the students will have the answers for me, being that they're so technologically proficient. What I want the students to learn especially is, I don't want them to talk about Christmas like they used to in primary. I don't want them to think, oh, Santa Claus and the reindeers and things like that. I want them to be critical, to be able to speak about Christmas and know what they're talking about. So what I have them do is research historically where Christmas comes from, who invented Santa Claus, why marketing strategies are working so well, see how companies use the marketing strategies and are influencing what they're doing, how they're celebrating Christmas also.
When I was younger, I had Barbies.
Hot Wheels cars.
I want them to learn more vocabulary, of course. I want them to integrate all of the grammar that we've been doing also. I chose Book Creator because I wanted the students to use computers. I was looking for something, an application somewhere, instead of writing paper and pencil, where the kids could be creative. Book Creator is fun because the kids could put a lot of pictures. The kids could make their own book and be proud of their book. Some of the students went to their primary classroom, their homeroom teacher, and they presented their book to the primary students, so that was a blast also. The next step for Book Creator, once the books are done, I'm going to publish the books, so allow the students in class to see what the other students have done, and I want them to write two things. I'm probably going to be using Padlet. So what I want them to do is, first of all, I want them to find something that they liked about the book, not pictures and stuff, but I want them to actually read the book and to comment on what they really liked about what was written in the book. And I also want them to give a suggestion, find something, give a suggestion to the author of the book, to say, well, what can you change to make it better, things like that. If I had to do this again, I would have students work on Google Doc first to get their text down, because some of the students were using too much time to go get pictures and make it pretty, but that doesn't count in the evaluation, so I think I would do that. The other reason why I would do Google Docs first is for correction purposes, because correcting directly on Book Creator was a little bit difficult. It took me a long time because there was a lot of clicks to do. You absolutely have to have the latest version of Google Chrome, otherwise things didn't work. Like for me, the recording, some of the kids were finished in advance and they wanted to record their book vocally, have an audio. And it didn't work in class because we didn't have a good version of our Google Chrome was obsolete. Some of the students were able to do it at home They were able to do their audio at home. The impact that I see on students with technology is that they are way more involved. When they have to create something, it is amazing to see the students, like their eyes just light up. And it's not paper pencil, it's being creative at the same time. So you get a lot more competencies in there. So it's fun for that.